My name is Ramakant. I'm a business analyst. I work for Business Technology.
Hi, I'm Srinivas from Capgemini. I have close to 8 years of experience in Agile. I do Agile coaching, transformation, and kind of empowering teams, Agile teams.
Hi, I'm Kanti. I'm new to Agile. I have a lot of daily experience, but I would like to learn, try to implement this. So that's where I'm here.
During our discussion, I think we're going to start seeing a little bit of repetition between what the other two teams already conveyed. In terms of our interpretation, the current mindset, everybody seems to be using Agile as a buzzword, and everybody wants to be seen as being Agile. Whether they are or are not is questionable and debatable. But then that's the trend. Everybody wants to be projected as being Agile. So there is apparent increased agile adaptation. However, there's a huge mindset change challenge that's also going on at this time. And that combines with some of the points we've already mentioned and this team also mentioned.
That's the reason we have come first, so that it not be
good for us. Very good for us. Management wants deliveries in agile, management themselves are not agile. That's part. In our discussion, we also found that adaptation to Agile is following a kind of set trend path. It's typically in the range of 8 to 14 months before we start waking up and understanding what the hell we're doing. Unfortunately, under the Agile umbrella, we do continue to see a traditional hierarchy keeping control. Although we have an SM, we have a PO, we're supposed to have team members, we land up having manager, architect, tester, developer, documenter, etc., etc., etc. So we're not really cross-functional, though we claim to be agile. These are all parts of the observations that we discussed, and it seems to be in line with what most of you are saying.
Most of the teams, they tend to follow our metrics, which is very close to our, which is very apt to what we call the traditional approach. Although they say that they are agile, they follow the traditional metrics like artifact slippage, disk execution, number of defects found, and all this stuff. But in agile, specifically, we need to focus more on what kind of value a team or a scrum team is delivering. So there are certain key aspects like effort variance, schedule variance, and commitment variance. These are certain things which are specific to Agile in addition to what we follow in traditional approach. So the focus should be more on the Agile metrics, not on the traditional kind of metrics. To keep track of what we are doing, where we are, and where we can do this. And certain things like, this is very key thing where multiple vendors are involved in any project delivery. So we don't see any knowledge repository. The team just do what is asked to do, but they don't maintain the repository, which is the reason why over a period of time it will become a kind of knowledge debt. Although they want to learn, they want to know, but there is no system that they can refer to. So it's very important to maintain a knowledge repository in a co-located, distributed, or multi-vendor, whatever we call it. And certain key things like definition of ready, definition of done, and working agreement, most of the team don't know about it. These are very important in Agile context, because without this, we cannot make product owner aligned to Agile. We cannot make teams for Agile. So in my opinion, with my 8 years of experience in Agile, what I say is any team, I just look for DOR, DOD, and working agreement. If there are no proper these things, then I just need to come up with this kind of checklist. They are more like a checklist. And certain things like scope, yeah. In Agile, always we can change the scope. We allow customer or our business teams to change the scope, but always the resources and the time sprint duration has to be fixed. But nowadays, I see a couple of teams or even client teams where they just compromise on the process and they move resources from one team to another, and they even delay certain release dates, so which is against Agile principles. So these are all there. Instead of following the process, we need to know look at the root cause, why it is happening. In my opinion, this scope, time and resources has to be given. Anything else to add?
Yeah, this one is also a kind of a negative trend that I personally, in my opinion, that is there's too much focus on certification without the applying the knowledge from the certifications. Everybody wants to be a certified dash, a professional dash, but that's where it starts and ends. And that's in line with what you were saying.
They want to be managed. Management wants them to be certified, and they want them to be that you are an HR. Just prove that you are an HR. What the implementation is in the project, they don't care.
Management wants to showcase it to the client.
Yes. That's the wrong
definition. And somebody mentioned earlier, so it's dangerous to say that if a waterfall took 12 months, I can give it to you in 6 months in agile. It is not true. It's not necessarily true. There's a hugely, I think this money talks and everything else talks. So I guess that's what it means. In terms of our future trends, from our discussion, Agile is definitely here to stay. Whether we remain as Scrum implementers or we start moving towards something like Lean and Kanban, that's possibly where things might head in our opinion, in our discussion. I just want to make one point before. What's going to be interesting as we, in the years to come, is scaling of Agile. We're right now very co-located, and as long as you're in the same building, etc., it's nice, all nice and comfortable. But if you have large teams, product development companies especially, spread across geographies, all working on a common project, scaling is going to be a huge challenge. It is a challenge, and it's going to be interesting to see how we're going to get more mature in terms of addressing those challenges.
In a multi-vendor kind of environment, we always see a challenge where one vendor tries to compete with other vendor, and even this kind of behavior might impact the deliverables. So it's a serious problem what I see as per my experience. And when it comes to future trend, I see a shift left concept where teams are going more towards left, where instead of teams focusing on functional testing after development is complete, now the trend is to do testing in parallel to development. And the teams are very competent enough, and the technology or competency skills are high enough, the testing can start even before the development work starts, provided there is a better framework, automation, VDD or TDD is made available to the testing or development teams. That is, VDD is picking up a lot, where like Uber, JBL, it's a new kind of combination. And coming to DevOps, so when we talk about Agile, nowadays Agile with DevOps is kind of a buzzword, where when we talk about any Agile team, we talk about programmers, testers and operations. But now with this DevOps concept, everything has to be so automated and so smooth, or things has to be in an automated mode. That moment code is checked into the source code repository, the system has to be intelligent enough to understand, know the changes, build it, kick off certain unit tests, VDD tests, then deploy it to a respective environment, and also kick off a respective regression or business value scripts. So that's how the system is supposed to be, and we are moving towards it. So the future is DevOps, where with minimal effort, we don't need to rely on any other team. We don't have to have a separate configuration management team who just do build, deploy, and let QA team to say that you just go ahead and check test it. So it is a system which takes care of everything, from the building to deployment to the testing, which is prerequisite. So when this is done, when shift left is done and DevOps is in place, testers, they don't need to spend much time on regression testing, because whatever testing they are supposed to do will be already done with the shift left as well as with the DevOps concept.